morning friends, my name is Praveen Kumar and I am here for taking the geography classes and I am very much happy to introduce a new module for geography prelims as well as mains, that is mapping. So in the last 4 to 5 years, the UPSC has asked the questions based on maps, and these number of the questions are near about 5 to 7 questions in every year. So in general, if you see the geography section for the prelims exam, so there the number of the questions are 12 to 20, right? And if you include this environment, this reaches to 30 to 35 question. Means 30 to 35 questions का भी मतलब हो गया कि about 35% paper is from the geography and environment section, right? Then after out of this 12 to 20 questions, there are 5 to 7 questions are from the maps, and 5 to 7 questions are absolute questions which are very easy to reach on the answer. How is it there? In the map questions, the one thing is clear, that map either you know or do not know. So in this section we cannot apply the concept. So either you know or do not know, that is the thing in the map questions. So therefore there this map is very important for the prelims exam. It also helps in the mains examination, that I will tell you how the map is important for the this mains examination, right? First let's see the prelims section. So here this section in the prelims examination, their mapping is or mapping comes with the practice, right? It is easy task, number one. Everyday practice will make you one day very much equipped or well known about the locations of the India or the world and the different aspects, right? So means in totality the geography section based on map is about more than 50%, or I would say 60 to 70% prelims questions in geography is maps, right? I hope you have understood this, the how or why the map is significant, right? Now the nature of the question in the map are of two types. Thank you. map questions. Map questions here. Word and India. Word and the India. Right? So, in this map section, India, we will take the topics or the areas which we are going to cover in the mapping section or the entire mapping classes. We will start with the geography of India first. Here we will talk all the physical features. Physical features. Right? In the physical features, before the physical features, I want to start with the political map. Political map of India. Now, here you see the political map of India. Political map of India. It is important, if you will see there, the class 2 student also knows the political map of India. He knows about the states, he knows about the capitals of the state, he knows about some of the cities, and some cities are important, like the historical city Agra, Jhansi, and many other cities are there which has a historical significance, cultural significance are also there. But here in this job, in the UPSC point of view, the political map is important because there you have to study this political map. You have to study the political map one level above the general information. This is level above general information in political map. Right, one level above the general information. It means if we are not only supposed to learn not only the states, its capital, cities, or rather I will say important cities. Right. So, these states, these capitals, these important cities, we have to study in the reference of each other. I hope you can interrelate the reference of each other. Means you have to study the state like northeastern region in respect of or in the reference of Kerala and Tamil Nadu. We will take that in the detail in the our detailed math class, right? In terms of physical aspect or the physical features, we will talk about the mountain, plateaus, plains, rivers, lakes, and then the peaks. These are the physical features. So these 7 important physical features are there which are required to know, because the mountains एंड वी कैन ऑल्सो से दिस एंड ग्लेशियर्स और वी कैन द पीक्स ऑल्सो हेयर प्लेट्यूज प्लेन रिवर्स लेक्स एंड द पीक्स. सो वी हैव टू टॉक अबाउट द रेस्पेक्ट ऑफ वन ईच अदर. सो दिस विल बी द एक्सटेंसिव सेक्शन इन द फिजिकल एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ द फिजिकल फीचर्स ऑफ द इंडिया मैपिंग राइट. देन आफ्टर इन द इकोनॉमिक एस्पेक्ट of mapping in India we will talk about waterways. Then after we will talk about some important national highways here we will talk about ports of India, right? Then after, in the environmental section, of the mapping, so we will talk about the Tiger reserves, bird sanctuaries, we will take all the important bird sanctuaries which has been in the news in the last 1 or 2 years. Ramsar sites. Right. Then after we will talk about the biosphere reserves. National parks. Right. I hope you are getting the idea. So we have divided our India mapping into the 4 sections. Number 1 is political. Number 2 is physical aspects. Number 3 is environment and number 4 is the economic aspects of the country. So out of this economic or out of this 4 section, I can assure you, you will be having the information more than 500 or in the range of 500 to 1000 locations. 500 to 1000 locations only in the case of India, right? So this 4 sections, this India mapping has been divided into the 4 sections. Out of this, you will not find the question beyond these 4 sections. The prelims examination, there are the questions are only in these 4 sections, right? Then after, in the case of the world mapping. World mapping has the 2 ways of asking the question. One is physical aspects or physical features, number 1. Number 2, they ask the question from this word mapping. They are based on the current affairs. Right, current affairs. So in this current affairs, they usually ask places which have been in the news in the last 1 or 2 years gap. So in this period, so the places we will talk about in the detail which has been there in the news in last 1 or 2 years period. Right. For example, in the 2019, four cities they had asked, which of the following were there in the news, or which of the following cities are located there in the Syria and the Turkey. So this type of the question they have been asking इन द वर्ल्ड, फिजिकल एस्पेक्ट्स एंड द करंट अफेयर. सो लार्ज है, लार्ज सेक्शन हैज बीन आस्क्ड देयर इन द इंडियन ज्योग्राफी, राइट. नाउ हियर द क्वेश्चन इज, देन आफ्टर इन द फिजिकल एस्पेक्ट्स, इन द फिजिकल एस्पेक्ट्स वी विल टेक एज ऑफ दिस, वी आर टेकिंग देयर इन द इंडिया माउंटेन्स, प्लेट्यूज, प्लेन्स, देन आफ्टर रिवर्स, लेक्स, इंपॉर्टेंट लेक्स, राइट. सो दिस विल बी द फिजिकल एस्पेक्ट एंड अमंग दीज आर फोकस विल बी इन द वर्ल्ड मैपिंग in the world mapping our focus will be on the two aspects. Number one is physical plus current affairs, right. So in this aspect we have, I have made a plan, we will go continent wise, one continent by the other. So in each continent we will draw all this, or we will locate all these physical aspects. Out of this continent, we will divide the continents into the different regions, wherever will be the possibilities. For example, first of all, I will take Asia, because Asia has been in the news, or very much in the news, in the last 2 years, and the different areas of the Asia has been in the absolute every day in the news because of one or the two reasons. So Asia region I have classified. We will talk about West Asia, West Asia, South Asia, Southeast Asia, East Asia, right. Thereafter, West Asia, South Asia, Southeast Asia, East Asia. What is important here? Four regions are there. I have taken the four regions: West Asia, South Asia, Southeast Asia, and East Asia. I have skipped, just notice it, I have skipped Central Asia. I am not taking the Central Asia in the map locations, just we will take only the countries and their neighboring regions for that. So because this region in terms of geopolitics is relatively least significant why this region Central Asia was important in the geopolitics till the Cold War or till the time when there was an issue in the Afghanistan or there was an issue in the Uzbekistan, which was the part of the Russia earlier. So till the Cold War, Central Asia was a part of the great concern or the focus. But now the Central Asia has become a least important in the recent time. So here we will focus more on these four areas in terms of mapping in Asia region, right. Then after, rest part we will take as usual with the North America, South America, Europe, Africa, Africa also we will split into different regions. Then after we have already taken the Asia, then after Australia. Then after the Australia. So this way we will cover all these physical aspects with continent wise, right? Here I want to just enter the second section of the mapping. We are taking the map, or we are giving the emphasis over the mapping. And UPSC has also asked the mapping in the UPSC has also asked the questions on the mapping, or especially focused over the locations, because mapping is important in terms of spatial analysis. Spatial analysis, right? Here in this mapping is important. So I want to draw your attention. Why mapping is needed, or why mapping is significant? Why mapping is significant for those people, those who are opting the non-geography optionals. So here I am not talking about the geography optional student. I am talking about generally GS students. Why mapping is important for non-geography optionals or the GS, right? Because here the mapping is important because, number one, you have one section in GS, GS paper 1, GS mains paper 1, you have section of history, right? So there was a person called Herodotus. You might have heard the name of the Herodotus, those who are having the history optional, or you will study the history. Herodotus was father of history. Father of history. Herodotus made a very, very important statement. History must be treated geographically and geography must be treated historically. History must be treated geographically, geography must be treated historically, right? In the history we study, Muhammad Ghaznavi came to India, Muhammad Ghori came to India, that Alexander also came to India. They took only one route from Central Asia or West Asia to India. That was बोलन पास, बोलन पास. एंड नाउ माय क्वेश्चन इज हाउ मेनी पीपल नो वेयर इज व्हाट इज द लोकेशन ऑफ बोलन पास, राइट? व्हाट इज द लोकेशन ऑफ द बोलन पास? सो फॉर दैट यू हैव टू गो इन ए ज्योग्राफी लोकेशन. आई होप यू विल अंडरस्टैंड हियर वेयर आई एम ट्राइंग टू ड्रॉ योर अटेंशन टूवर्ड्स द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ द मैपिंग हियर, मैपिंग ऑफ इंडिया, मैपिंग ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. इफ यू नो दे व्हाट इज द लोकेशन ऑफ द बोलन पास, यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड, यू कैन कॉन्सेप्चुअली अंडरस्टैंड how the invaders from the western asia, they had the easy access to the indus plain. Earlier india was extending up to the pakistan region, so they had the accessibility, easy accessibility to the indus plain through or via bolan pass. So who is important? Geography. Then after, why invaders attracted towards east? So you can have this question also in the mains or the prelims sometime. Why the invaders attracted towards the east only? Because there was a vast land which was drained or flowed by the river Indus and its tributaries, which provided or which offered the fertile land in the Indus plain and the Gangetic plain. So that land was very rich in the agriculture. So that land was this producing the huge quantum of the crops. It offered a very very basic or fundamental sources for the growth of the civilization. People flourished. You have heard about the Indus Valley civilization. So Herodotus was absolutely perfect. The history must be treated geographically. If we have the knowledge of the geography, if we know the geography of the region, we can study history better. We can write the geographical concept in the history, or we can interrelate the geography and the history. Your answer will become absolutely qualitative, other than the political aspects in the history. Your answer will become qualitative if you have the geographical only mapping aspects are strong. You can write the better answer in the history. So you will give the way how the history has opened, or the how the history has taken place on the basis of the geographical concept or the geographical grounds. Geography mapping is important for the history. Like when you will study about this 1857 revolt, there the different locations are there. If you do not know, you will not be able to understand the geography, history exactly in the proper ways. Number two, international relation. जिसको हम बोलते हैं IR. The role of geography in the international relation. Many students ask me, sir, how this international relation and geography is important? It is totally geopolitics. It is totally a relationship between the two countries. I tell you one thing there. You must have heard about the साउथ चाइना ईस्ट नंबर वन देर इज द डिस्प्यूट बिटवीन इंडिया एंड चाइना ऑन द डोकलाम इशू ऑन द डोकलाम रीजन राइट रिसेंटली नाउअडेज द इश्यू इज गोइंग ऑन द लद्दाख रीजन व्हाट वी कॉल इट इज अक्साई चीन राइट रिसेंटली देर इज गोइंग इश्यू बिटवीन इंडियन इंडिया 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 नेपाल दैट इज कालापानी डिस्प्यूट बिटवीन इंडिया नेपाल नाउ आई हैव गिवन यू दिस एस्पेक्ट्स इट इज फार ऑफ इज फार ऑफ फ्रॉम इंडिया बट दीज आर द डिस्प्यूट्स विच हैज द बॉर्डर शेयर विद इंडिया इट इज बॉर्डर डिस्प्यूट्स ऑफ इंडिया बॉर्डर डिस्प्यूट्स ऑफ इंडिया सो हियर इन द आई आर इफ यू टॉक अबाउट ऑन द साउथ चाइना इश्यू साउथ चाइना इश्यू इज ए प्रॉब्लम बिटवीन और द साउथ चाइना इश्यू इज ए इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज दिस इज ए वेरी वास्ट सी एरिया विच इज फुल ऑफ मरीन रिसोर्स मरीन रिसोर्सेस रिसोर्स आई एम टेलिंग यू रिसोर्स रिसोर्स इज ज्योग्राफिकल ज्योग्राफिकल एंटिटी ज्योग्राफिकल एंटिटी नाउ इफ यू नो द रिसोर्स रिजर्व इन द साउथ चाइना सी यू कैन इजीली रीच टू द कॉजेस and interrelations then after you will analyze yourself what will be the result of this issue right so marine resource like fishing petroleum trade route three areas are there one is trade route one is fishing one is the petroleum All are plenty in the South China Sea. South China is surrounded by the Taiwan, Philippines. Then after, or South China Sea is bordered by the Taiwan, Philippines, Vietnam. Then after there is Borneo, and then after the China. So these countries having their territorial water. Exclusive economic zone in the South China Sea. So these countries they have equal right to extract the petroleum or the any of the resource from the sea. But in order to have the greed of expansion of the territory by China, they are occupying, they are encroaching the water of the or the sea area. Claiming them that those areas are in the territory of China on the basis of nine edge line on the basis of nine edge line and 11 edge line nine edge line and the 11 edge line so 11 edge line expands the more areas of the China in the South China Sea. So what is the intention of China? China want to grab or claim all the marine rich resources in the South China Sea. Then after they want to block the trade route which is easily accessible to the Japan. So it wants to target to the Japan also. Why the South China Sea, not in the eastern part of the Pacific or the east of the Philippines and the other areas? Because that part is relatively disturbed in terms of the geography or climatologically, or in terms of the climate, that is disturbed area, because there the frequent cyclones are there. That is a disturbed area. But this South China Sea, when it is surrounded by the islands, there is a relatively less effect. And it is a shallow water. East of the Philippines, east of the Taiwan, east of this Japan, that is a deep sea, and extracting the resource from the deep sea in the West Pacific is not exactly possible. South China Sea is a shallow sea. So therefore, it is the need or the demand of the China to have the issue, they have the encroaching on the South China Sea. How we have known this? Because of this resource. So that resource, if we have the information about the resources through the geographical location, we only know why this is important. Doklam issue. So my idea is, my concern is, when you write the answer in the mains examination, suppose the question is on the Kalapani. So when you are writing the answer on the Kalapani, so what you should do? It will take hardly 20 or 30 seconds. When you practice it, it will take hardly 20 or 30 seconds. This is right here, India, Nepal. This is the issue. You have made this. Put that in the box. Now you are writing the issue. Whatever the issue you want to, whatever the issue is there, you write it there in the text. With that, make this map. What the examiner will do? Examiner will look at this map. He will see the region, slightly go on the text, where if the question is of 10 marks, you will definitely get. If you do not make the map or you simply write the theories, you will get 5 out of 10. If you draw the map or you give the map with your answer, you will get 7 out of 10. Right? So this is the significance of the mapping, or this is the significance of mapping in writing the answer in the mains. So I tell all the students, all my students, whether it is geography, whether it is economics, polity, IR, whatever the topics are there, must make the map. But for that, you have to learn the mapping. Right? For that, you have to learn the mapping. So mapping is by the practice. So there you can write the, this draw the map. So we will continue with this, our mapping classes. Every day, each locations, as we have talked about our plan, their physical aspects in terms of the mountain plateau and all, in terms of the political map, we will start with the political map of India, and gradually we will go. Thank you. I hope you have understood the concept why the mapping is important. So this way you can go for the mapping in the mains examination, and of course prelims examination the mapping is there, because 5 to 7 questions are always there. So I wish you all the best. Thank you very much.